Hello. Today we are exploring darkness. We are going to make an ecosystem that sees only darkness to see what will happen if an ecosystem exists in only darkness. You see, a few years ago I made an ecosphere that only sees light, a closed ecosystem lit by the sun by day and lit by artificial lightning at night. Many of you wondered, including myself, what would happen if we were to make an ecosystem that only saw darkness. Today we are going to find out. I'm not going to make a closed ecosystem because there still needs to be a source of oxygen. And if that source of oxygen is not plants and algae making it themselves using light, then we need to have air exchange in order for all the organisms in the jar to have oxygen. So it will be an open ecosystem in a jar, and it will also, of course, not add any plants. So let's go outside and make one. I mean, darkness. Alrighty, so I went outside with my jar and filled it with sediment, which smelled fantastic. After I felt it had enough sediment, I filled it with water. Now it was time for the water to clear up so I could actually see something. I could already see a tiny gamete in the upper layer of the water. Really tiny. It must be very young. Cute! A day later, the water became a bit clearer. This is a worm. It's a kind of worm I've never seen before. It's quite long, I'd say about 5 or 6 centimeters or about 2 inches, and it has many tentacles that wave back and forth. Well, long is relative, of course. It's long compared to most worms I see in my ecosystems, but tiny compared to the African giant earthworm, Microrhizus rapi, which can get up to 7 meters long. Here we have another gamete, or scud, as some of you might know it. This one is carrying eggs, which is where the little ones come from. Maybe you didn't know that. And in this leaf stalk resides a chironomid mosquito larva. This worm got spooked by something and is now slowly coming out of the sediment again. It got spooked again by an aquatic isopod. Yes, they are also present in this jar. And has now given up. Or has it? The next day, so 2 days after the jar was filled, the water has gotten quite clear. Time to store it away in a dark place. But not without looking what lives in there first, of course. Here we have a buried gamete female. Buried meaning she is carrying eggs. We don't often see gametes or scuds in my projects, apart of course from the killer shrimp aquarium, so it's nice to see them in here. I imagine they will fare fairly well in a dark environment, as they can eat practically anything and usually live off decaying organic matter, which there is and will be more than enough of in this jar. I guess it's breeding season for these scuds because there are many, many bebes. Here you can see them hanging out on the leaf stalk with the mosquito larva, who performs a little dance for them. As it turned out, there wasn't just one of these worms, but quite a few. I find it very interesting that I've never seen worms like these in my life, and suddenly they're here. I feel like it's probably a very common species which I, by chance, never saw before. I haven't been able to figure out what kind of worm it is exactly, so if you know, please let me know, as I'm very curious. I know it's an annelid, or segmented worm, which doesn't really help us.
I'm almost certain it's in the class of Clitellata, and fairly certain it's in the subclass of Oligochaeta. From there, I guess it's in the order of Lumbriculida, but that's as far as I dare to go. Whatever they are, I think they should probably do quite well in a dark environment as well, as most worms do. They're so unique and weird looking, and like I said before, quite long for jar worms. The bladder snail, Fissa fontinalis, also blessed this jar with its presence. Although they enjoy scraping algae off the glass of the jar, they are omnivores and quite indestructible, so they should be okay in a dark environment. The same goes for these tiny freshwater limpet snails. Cute! This jar also houses the usual tiny crustaceans like copepods and daphnia, which might have a little more trouble as they eat a lot of unicellular algae. They also eat other particulate organic matter though, so I guess we'll see. So, this is what the jar looks like before the start of the experiment. Let it soak in a bit. I actually really like the way this jar looks. I might make an aquarium that looks like this. Let me know what you would think about that. Alright, time to put the jar away, but not before taking a bit of a closer look. There honestly wasn't that much to see, except for some really tiny microbes zooming around really quickly. Those were quite abundant. When I also took a sample from the sediment, I expected to see quite a bit more, but there just wasn't that much there. I did see this little guy, some sort of ciliate. I also saw this guy, a diatom, a very large diatom actually, the biggest I've ever seen myself. Unfortunately, I have nothing in the video to scale it against. I was hoping to see a little more microbes, so we could also see how darkness affects the smaller residents in this ecosystem, but I guess these will have to do. Since diatoms like sunlight, they probably won't enjoy darkness very much, but again, we'll see. Alright, now it's finally time to put it away.
A week's worth of events happened.
Time to take it out of the dark after exactly a week. As soon as I moved this jar, lots of bubbles came out of the sediment. You can still see some of them at the water surface. Those are probably gases formed by anaerobic bacteria in the substrate, so there was probably very little oxygen there. It looks pretty much the same. If I put it under my nose, there's a little bit of a weird smell, but it's really not too bad, and I don't notice it if I don't put it right under my nose. This bladder snail was already trying to steal the spotlight in a previous shot, so let's actually give it the spotlight. Why not? It's feeling good and wants to show it. Really good, actually. Do you see the gelatinous blob filled with little dots right next to the scut? Those are snail eggs, so it must be feeling good. Speaking of eggs, this gemmeret is not carrying eggs anymore, nor is this one. But the little daphnia over here is actually full of eggs. You know what's funny? In a way, eggs are the products of previous eggs, which are also the products of eggs, of eggs, of eggs, 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 and here we have another product of an egg, this chironomid mosquito larva in its leaf stalk. Still dancing. The limpet snails also seem to be doing fine. There's quite a few teeny tiny scuds. They are really small, even smaller than the ones we saw a week ago. Ridiculously small. Look, here you can compare it to the snail. They are, of course, the babies of the females that don't have their eggs anymore. They were born somewhere in the past week and have therefore known nothing but darkness for their entire existence. Until now, there's really quite a lot of them. Look, these copper pots are also carrying eggs. This jar is so unbelievably eggy right now. Look, it's a snail gliding over another snail. In this case, a bladder snail and a limpet snail. You don't see that every day. You can start to see this every day though, by simply watching this video every day. Sounds like a fantastic idea, right? I mean, who's joining? Here's another copper pot, but the snail keeps stealing the spotlight. I don't think I've ever had limpets in a closed ecosystem before. Maybe I should try it once. Let me know what you think. I want to know what you think. I want to know your thoughts. I want to be inside your mind. What? Look, a copper pot. Of course, now I know that you're wondering what happened to those worms. They're doing absolutely fine. But moving the jar always startles worms a bit. And by the time they'll come out again, the jar will be back in the dark. For now, this underground footage of the worms will have to do. Here's two of them. There's also a new inhabitant I didn't see before. This really tiny mosquito larva. It might be a very small species of mosquito, but it might also be a very young larva that hatched from an egg very recently. In which case, this just might be the first time it's seeing light. After being in complete darkness for a week, the jar still looks pretty much the same. Honestly, I wasn't expecting much to happen after just a week, especially since there's no plants in there. Those probably would have died. But still, it's nice to see that everything didn't die. Time to put it away again, but not without taking a bit of a closer look. I didn't find the diatom from a week ago, but I did see a bunch of other diatoms. Oh hey, here's a little friend zooming past. I also saw quite a few of these ciliates. It's time. I'll top off the water and put it back in its dark hole, after having seen the light for exactly 55 minutes. Alright, so after a week, nothing really happened, which is kind of to be expected, because there are no organisms in the jar right now that need light to survive from day to day, like plants and algae for instance. Nothing really died yet. And I also don't necessarily think that a lot of animals will die. I think quite a lot stand a fighting chance. I just wanted to show you what happened in a week because I thought it was fun and I hope you did too. So it's going to be interesting to see what will happen in the long run for this ecosystem. So I think, but I'm not going to make any promises, that I'll do maybe a month update or a 6 month update, a year update, something like that. I think most organisms would do quite well actually. I think the worms for instance, the scuds, the aquatic isopods, the snails, they are all organisms that don't necessarily need light and that also are omnivores and or even detrivores, so eating dead or decaying organic matter, which there is enough of in the jar and there will be enough of, I think. The Daphnia and the copepods and the other smaller crustaceans that are filter feeders that feed usually mostly on algae might have a bit more of a harder time. That's not to say that they will definitely die out, because they also eat smaller bacteria and protozoans and
really any particulate organic matter in the water. Algae is an important part of their diet, so we will see. This is a bit of an experimental video and an experimental experiment, as most experiments are. Still, I hope you enjoyed it. I know I did. It was fun to see different organisms than usual for once. I will see you guys in the future updates, and thanks for watching.